What it do, cuckolds? It's your boy, the Hater, up in this mug. And I wanted to make a video about wrestling as a medium and how far it has gone and how much it has changed. Now, a lot of people, when they talk about the drop in viewership, obviously they harken back to the Attitude Era, because the Attitude Era was when wrestling was popular and good. And incorrectly, I think, a lot of people, sometimes myself included, they attribute this just to the fact that after the Attitude Era, or, you know, shortly thereafter, wrestling became PG, you know? And that's certainly a part of it. But I don't think it's the most important part. And it certainly is not the only thing that changed. In my opinion, the bigger change that happened is something far more innocuous, but it really shouldn't have been so innocuous. Like, as a matter of fact, we shouldn't tolerate this. And I think a lot of people don't tolerate this, which is why they switched the channel, right? Now, the Hater is an immigrant. And when the Hater came to the United States of America, the Hater didn't like American football. And quite frankly, I still really can't get behind it, because I don't like a sport. Like, I don't care if those people are the biggest athletes of all time. It doesn't matter, because they play for one play. It takes like 8 seconds. Then there's like 5 minutes of commercial every time. You know what I mean? Like a football game, I think they've measured it. It's like 7 minutes of actual activity. And the rest is like the clock counting down and like a bunch of other bullshit, right? Even if every second counted, which it doesn't, a lot of times the clock just, you know, just keeps running while they show replays and things like that. The game itself takes 4 hours, but you have 1 hour of actual in-game clock. Now, I'm not saying, like, I get it. People like football. I enjoy it sometimes. It can get very, very tense, very, very entertaining. But wrestling was the antidote to that in the past. Now, wrestling has followed this football format, right? Where it's just this overproduced mess where nothing really happens except for, like, you know, in a 3 hour segment, there's like 6-7 minutes worthy of watching, right? Now, it's not just that, you know, obviously Sami Zayn is not as good as, like, you know, Matt Hardy version one, or Kevin Owens is not as good as, like, you know, Val Venus or The Rock or S.A. Rios. It's not just that. Again, that's part of it. But I think what it is this like expectation that WWE and other wrestling programs have of the viewer to sit through commercials in the middle of a match. There is nothing else that I can think of off the top of my head where this happens, right? Like, football found a way to do it. They have like 2 hours of commercials every game, right? But they make it part of the game almost, right? About, oh, someone's hurt on the field. We'll be right back, right? And they throw like 3 commercials about some, you know, medication that you probably don't need. You know what I mean? So, but in wrestling, and this doesn't happen in TV shows of any sort, right? In wrestling, it's like, oh, the thing that you're watching is going to keep happening, but we're going to go to commercial break. And you're going to miss part of it. That's just how it is, right? Like, in the middle of a match, like, imagine if it was any other sport. Imagine you're watching an NBA game, right? And LeBron's about to take a free throw, and they're like, ah, commercial break. And then you come back and, like, the Lakers are winning by 10 points. You know, the game was tied, now they're winning by 10 points. You're like, what the fuck just happened, right? Exactly, right? For some reason, this is an acceptable thing in wrestling. It's not acceptable in any other TV show ever in the history of TV. It's never acceptable to cut something in half and be like, that's it, commercial break. You wait until the thing ends, then you do a commercial break. Now I understand. Wrestling is presented as 3 continuous hours of entertainment or of programming, right? Even though it isn't. Like, one time I went to a random episode of Raw where basically there was like a Jeff Hardy match, and the match ended with Jeff Hardy being, what's it called? 5-star frog splashed by Rob Van Dam. Van Dam won the match. Jeff Hardy was on the mat for the entire commercial break. Then he gets up, and Shawn Michaels comes to the ring and super kicks him. And then Jeff Hardy, and then there's another commercial break, and Jeff Hardy's laying on the mat again, right? So Jeff Hardy's like laying down for like 10 minutes on the mat, selling the 5-star frog splash and the sweet shit music. Like, nothing else happened. It was just a commercial break and nothing happened, right? That happens too in Monday Night Raw. But think about what we're saying here, right? We have boring things like entrances. Like, if you watch Raw like on TV and you watch it live, you know that this happens all the time, where Michael Cole will be like, oh, up next is Randy Orton versus Kevin Owens in a ass strap match, right? And then they come back, and Michael Cole says, welcome back. And then you hear, I have voices in my head. And then Randy Orton comes out. It takes him like 5 minutes. Then you hear Kevin Owens' shitty music. He comes out, takes him 3 minutes. It's been 8 minutes. And now the bell rings, and Michael Cole's like, all right. And then Owens just like gets out of the ring, and he's like, I don't want to fight, right? And then Michael's like, Owens is a coward. We'll be right back, right? And it's like, you just made me watch 8 minutes of entrance. Why don't you show that during the commercial break? Show that during the commercial break, and then let me know that they came into the ring, you know? And then I can watch the actual match. You see what I'm saying? Now, when Vince Russo was behind this, and again, I'm not saying just Vince Russo, but I'm using him as a marker, if you will, for what I'm talking about. When other people were in charge of this, right, things were different. You see what I'm saying? Things were fundamentally different. And the way it worked was the segment ended, then there was commercial. Then commercial ends, a new segment begins, and that segment somehow is going to have to end before the next commercial break. That's just how it is. And then maybe very, very rarely, you know, there might be a match that gets like, you know, cut out or something. I don't know. But generally speaking, it's like each slot between commercials was its own segment. Now a segment can last like 3 commercial breaks. It's like the match is like 15 minutes and we get to watch like 4 minutes of it. Now, granted, with today's wrestlers, I don't want to see more than 4 minutes. But if I have to see 15 minutes of something, I'd rather see the match than see Karrion Kross's entrance, which I've seen 100 times, you know? Like, the people that are there are gonna see the entrance anyways, right? The people that are in attendance. Why should I have to see it, you know? Now, again, some people love the entrance, and no one's saying, like, that my way is the best way, but clearly, my way is the best way, because my way generated 8 million views, and this way generates like 2 million views if they're lucky. So a lot of people have focused on like the actual product, but it's, in my opinion, it's more so the presentation, right? Because we do have glimpses of good things. Like, for example, the Judgment Day is a pretty entertaining thing on Raw. Like, if you had like three or four more programs on Raw that were like the Judgment Day, and you didn't have, for example, any that were like the Wyatt Six, it would be a very good show, right? You'd be like, oh shit, so much is happening. But that's not what happens, right? They have shit programs, but the presentation is atrocious. Like, think about how much time is spent on entrances. And I know people work hard on entrances. I'm not saying, you know, that they're useless, but you get my drift, right? The presentation of wrestling has gone from like, you tune in and it's just balls to the wall. 2 hours of extreme fun. Like, I don't know if anyone else had this experience, but I'll share a very interesting one that I thought of recently. Like, when the Hater was in middle school and high school, the Hater had this white alarm clock, right? Which the Hater loved very dearly. Actually, no, back then I didn't give a fuck. But now I miss that alarm clock because it was really cool. And this alarm clock, you know, was obviously also a normal clock. And it showed the time. And it wasn't rare for the Hater to come back home at like 2:30 from high school, maybe, right? I would try to get my homework done as soon as possible. Maybe I'd take a break, you know, then I'd do my homework. And my goal was to be done with homework by like, as soon as possible, obviously, right? But let's say I finished by like 5:30, right? Then what I would do is I would like take a shower, and then I would have my mom make me food. And on Mondays, I would play video games or something like that. And there was almost no way that I'd be out on Mondays because fucking Monday Night Raw was on, motherfuckers. So I would, you know, get some food, and then around 8, I'd watch Fear Factor with Joe Rogan. Then eventually I'd watch Raw, right? And sometimes, depending on the year, there were some things on at like 7 o'clock, right? Around 8:55, the Hater would look at his alarm clock, and he would get excited because it was almost 9 p.m., which meant that Raw was about to start, motherfuckers. Back in the day, Raw was 2 hours, 9 to 11. And I would wait for 8:55. I'd go, I'd take a piss, I'd get myself like some water or some Coke or juice or something, and I would sit next to my bed and I would mark out as I'm watching Raw. Now, this was before we had like smartphones, and it really was, part of this at least, when I was in middle school, was before the internet was really a thing. Like, we had the internet, but like, nobody really went to talk like on instant messenger and things like that, right? So I would just fucking sit there, watch the commercials, maybe like, you know, read like a video game manual or like a magazine or do something while I wait, right? And I always remember getting very, very depressed, like very, very sad when my alarm clock said 10:10, right? Because I knew that we were more than halfway done with Raw. And I knew that that meant that in about an hour, I'd finish Raw and I'd go to bed. You see what I'm saying? This was a very sad moment. Now, I fucking can't wait till Raw is over so I can like go and do a Raw review, which I enjoy much more. You see what I'm saying? Raw was can't miss TV. And I know that at least someone that's at some point gonna watch this video is going to resonate with my alarm clock story, with that dread that a school kid may have of, fuck, this is the best day of the week. Monday Night Raw, right? I get to watch Raw, motherfucks. And now it's over. I gotta wait another week to watch more Raw. Some of my favorite moments and some of the best things about wrestling came because I found wrestling to be a very interesting medium. Even when I was a kid, I didn't know what the word medium meant, but I found it to be interesting. And nowadays, we have a whole generation who doesn't. And that's very sad. So, why don't we go back to what used to work, cucks? Why don't we go back to what used to work?